Today we are going to discuss about question asked by JEE Main or AIEEE in Gaseous State Chapter. One by one we will solve the problem and understand the process of solving problem in gaseous state. So let us start. First problem was asked in 2002, which is question number 1. For an ideal gas, number of moles per liter in terms of its pressure P, gas constant R and temperature T is, A option is PT by R, B option is PRT, C option is P by RT, and D option is RT by P. This is the question asked by JEE Main in 2002. AIEEE 2002. In question it is asking that for an ideal gas, number of moles per liter in terms of pressure, gas constant and temperature is. Very easy question. We know that PV is equal to nRT. We have to find out mole per liter. So N by V will be simply equal to RT by P. This is the answer. Number of mole per liter will be expressed as RT by P. Volume per liter, mole per liter is easily expressed as, you can tell that RT by P. N by V is equal to P by RT. This will be equal to P by RT. And hence the option, correct option will be P by RT. Not molar volume. I was thinking about molar volume. In question it is asked that number of moles per liter. So N by V I have to calculate. N by V, if you put V on this side, then P by RT will be the correct answer. So C is the correct answer. Question number 2. Value of gas constant R is. Very easy questions. These are R is. This was also asked in 2002. In this question, options was 0.082 liter atm. B option was 0.987 calorie per mole per Kelvin. C option was 8.3 joule per mole per Kelvin. And D option was 83 arg per mole per Kelvin. These are the options, four options which I have to think about. R, the value of R is, you easily know that the value of R, R has a unit of atm liter per mole per Kelvin. In this value is 0.0821. If you expressed R in joule per mole per Kelvin, its value will be equal to 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin. And if you will express in calorie per mole per Kelvin, then its value will be equal to 1.98. So the correct answer is 8.3 joule per mole per Kelvin. You should also consider the unit of the R, because in first option 0.0821 liter atm is correct, but per mole per Kelvin is not given. So the correct answer will be 8.3 joule per mole per Kelvin. Now next question was asked in 2002 again. Three questions were asked in 2002. Question number 3 is, This was also question asked in 2002 itself. Kinetic theory of gases. Kinetic theory of gases proves A option is only Boyle's law. Boyle's law. B option is only Charles law. Charles law. C option is only Avogadro law. Avogadro's law. And D option is all of these. You can easily see that the correct answer will be all of these, because kinetic theory of gases was given to prove to kinetic theory of gases is given to understand the ideal gas behavior, and all these laws are for ideal gases, and hence kinetic theory of gases will prove, will explain any of the ideal gas behavior, any of the ideal gas law. Question number 4. According to kinetic theory of gases, in an ideal gas, between two successive, collision, gas molecules travel in A wavy path, wave ki tarah move, B option is in a straight line, C option is with an accelerated velocity, and D option is in a circular path. The correct answer will be in a straight line path. You easily know that the assumption of kinetic theory of gases says that between any two successive collisions, gas have tendency to move in a straight line path. Gas move in a straight line, but due to collision they follow zigzag path. So between any two collision, the gas will move in straight line path. This was the question asked in 2003. Question number 5. As temperature is raised, from 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius, the average kinetic energy, of neon atom, changes by a factor of A option 313 by 293, B option 313 by 293, C option is half, and D option is 2. This was the question asked by JEE Main in 2004. Look, we know that average translational kinetic energy, is directly proportional to temperature. Actually, you know that 3 by 2 nRT will be the correct option, relation between average translational kinetic energy and temperature. It should be remembered in mind that it is in Kelvin unit. Temperature is in Kelvin unit. So, if you raise the temperature from 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius, the temperature will raise from 293 to 313 Kelvin. So, the average translational kinetic energy will increase by a factor of this one. Only in this question, one should have remember in mind that the temperature to which average translational kinetic energy is related is in Kelvin unit. So if you keep it as everything category is 2 divided by category 1 will be equal to T2 by T1, and that will be equal to 273 plus 40 divided by 273 plus 20, and it will be equal to 313 divided by 293. So correct answer will be A. In next question, was also asked in 2004, question number 6, in which it is asked that in the van der Waal equation, in the van der Waal equation of gas, the constant B is a measure of A option is volume occupied by gaseous molecule. Volume occupied by gaseous molecules. B option is intermolecular force. Of attraction. C option is intramolecular force of attraction. D option is intermolecular collision. Per unit ball. You can easily see that the correct answer is A option. This was the question asked by EEE in 2004. It is, you must have known that, because van der Waal equation B is related as 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube into Avogadro number. It means that 4 times molar volume of gaseous molecule. This is the relation between B and gaseous molecule. So B clearly represent volume occupied by gaseous molecule. Actually, it is told that it is excluded volume occupied by gaseous molecule. That's why 4 times we have taken. Because excluded volume will be different from the volume occupied by gaseous molecule. But it is related to gaseous molecule volume. Question number 7. Which of the following statement? Is not true about the effect of increase in temperature. On the distribution of molecular speed in a gas. On the distribution of molecular speed in a gas. This was the question asked by AAA in 2005. The area under the distribution curve remains same as under the lower temperature. This is correct statement, because area under the MBVD diagram will give total fraction of molecules moving with every speed, all speed, which will be equal to 1, no matter how much the temperature is. This will be the correct option because area under the MBVD diagram will give total fraction of molecules which is equal to 1 at all temperature. No matter how much the temperature is, you will have always the value of 1 because total fraction will be equal to 1. So MBVD diagram, in MBVD diagram, area under the curve is independent from the temperature. B. The distribution becomes broader. This is also correct because as you increase the temperature, more number of molecules are moving with higher speed. So curve will become less sharper. I am plotting the curve to make you understand in easy way. This is the MBVD diagram. This is V, NVYN0. This is NVYN0. At lower temperature, you will have this one. At higher temperature, you will have this one. At more higher temperature, T1, T2, T1 is less than T2. So as you increase the temperature, more number of molecules are moving with higher speed and hence the curve becomes broader. Area under the curve remains same. C option is the fraction of molecules, with most probable speed, increases. This is the C option. This is wrong. You can clearly see that this is the MPS, VMPS 1, and fraction is here. This is MPS, VMPS 2. As temperature increases, VMPS increases, but fraction of molecules moving with MPS decreases. So C will be the correct option for this question because in question it is asked that which is not true for the effect of increase in temperature on distribution of molecular speed of a gas. So this is C is the correct option, the most probable speed increases. This is also correct, you can easily see that. The most probable speed increases. This is clearly correct because as you increase the temperature, most probable speed increases. You also know that relationship between VMPS and temperature. VMPS is directly related to temperature with under root. So as you increase the temperature, most probable speed increases. As you increase the temperature, fraction of molecules moving with VMPS decreases. In this options given, it is given that the fraction of molecules moving with most probable speed increases. So this is the incorrect option. So we have to tick out it. So this was the question asked by AIEEE or JEE Main in gaseous state chapter. In next class, we will discuss some more problem asked by JEE Main in gaseous state chapter.